As gold in the furnace, the Lord put his chosen to the test. As sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. And in due time, they will be honored, and grace and peace will be with the elect of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Good evening, my dear friends. A very warm welcome to all of you who are joining us for this celebration of the Eucharist from wherever you are joining us from, whether here in Clapham or around the country or around the world, you are most welcome. Today we celebrate the memorial of St. Charles Lwanga and companions, the Uganda martyrs. My dear friends, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. asked them if they were going to remain Christians, and they said, till death. And he said, then put them to death. I was amazed by their courage. They just received a new religion. They began following something new to them, but they followed from the moment they received the faith in Jesus Christ with so much urge, with so much great faith. They put in so much in what they come to know Jesus Christ. They put in so much trust to the extent that they gave up everything. As we know, these men and this group of people were serving in the king's courtyard. Most of them held very revered positions in the courts and the king's court. But they were not willing to give up everything for the sake of this new faith that had been given to them and the person they had come to know, and that is Jesus Christ. And I always wondered why. And I've come also through reading St. Paul to the knowledge, especially in today's first reading, his second letter to Timothy. He says at the end of the passage, I have not lost confidence because I know who it is that I have put my trust in. And I have no doubt at all that he is able to take care of all that I have entrusted to him until that day. And I think that is what defined the Ugandan matter. They had every confidence in whom they may trust him, and that is in Jesus Christ, that he's able to do anything. And I think, my dear friends, we are all tested in our faith. We do suffer naturally, as we know. It might not be by shedding our blood, but every single day of our life in faith, it is tested. Our patience is tested. Our forgiveness is tested. Our ability to show mercy is tested. Our ability to be charitable is tested. Everything about us is put to the test. And the moment, every moment we exercise forgiveness, every moment we exercise mercy, every moment, every time we exercise charity, our Mother of Perpetual Cycle to ask for her intercession as we say. Mother of Perpetual Help, with the greatest confidence, we come before your holy picture to beseech your intercession. We think of your mother at the foot of the cross. Your heart must have bled to see your son in agony. But your joy was great when he rose from the dead, victorious over the powers of evil. Mother of Souls, pray for us in this time of trial. Help us not to lose heart. Intercede for your people who are afflicted with coronavirus. Comfort your people who are vulnerable and anxious. Protect healthcare workers who put their lives at risk. Inspire our leaders to make good decisions. Change our hearts so that we may act responsibly. Teach us to trust in God's love and mercy, and to share with you the joy of having courageously faced up to all the challenges of life. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, for creation, for pilgrimages have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. We offer you sacrifice, O Lord, humbly praying that as you granted the Blessed Martyrs grace to die rather than sin, so you may bring us to minister at your altar in dedication to you, our Lord, through Christ our Lord. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith, to their endurance you grant them resolve, and in their struggle the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim, holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you. similar way when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith, when we hear this prayer, address us all, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and then you come again, and then you come.
Remember, Lord, the gesture throughout the world, and bring us the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, and we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, his spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Charles Lwanga, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit your grace for eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the service commanded for when you by teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, our Lord be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we always live from sin, and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, we say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant their peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you all." Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. My dear friends, I now invite you at this moment to make your own act of spiritual communion as we follow the words by St. Alphonsus Liguori. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself only to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Our precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his holy ones. Alleluia. Let us pray. We have received this divine sacrament, O Lord, as we celebrate the victory of your holy martyrs. May what helped them to endure torment, we pray, make us in the face of trials steadfast in faith and in charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you all for having shared with us the celebration of the Eucharist here at St. Mary's House in Clapham. I would like to take this opportunity to wish you all a pleasant evening. The Lord